Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to use our reverse sales tax calculator. So by the end of this video, if you only have total sales and you know the sales tax rate, we're going to show you how to get the sales without the tax rate in there, like we have right here in column D.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So usually a tax calculator takes an amount and then multiplies 100% plus the tax rate to give you the final value. So for example, let's just say I have a $10 bill and I'm going to have 0.1, which is 10% to my bill. So normally I would do equals my pre-taxed amount times in parentheses 1 plus my sales tax rate, close my parentheses and hit enter. So $11 is correct here because my pre-tax sales were 10 and then I added 10% to 10, which is 1, and it gave me 11. But remember, in this calculation, I'm doing 1 plus the sales tax rate, so I can include the initial amount in this calculation. But this is called our reverse sales tax calculator because this number here, the 11, we have right here in column B. And the sales rate right here, we have in column C. And we actually want to calculate this number right here, the initial number. So if I look at my original numbers right here, and I look at my final solution, I would just do the opposite. So instead of multiplying 1.1 by this first number, I now have this last number, and I'm going to divide by 1.1.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Here, and I type equals, and I have my total sales with tax, and then I press divided by, and in parentheses, 1 plus my sales tax rate. Close my parentheses and hit enter. I can see this is 23,000, and that is less than this number. And this is my number that's just like my 10 over here. And in fact, if I type equals this times, in parentheses, 1 plus my sales tax rate right here, close my parentheses and hit enter, I can see that I'm getting back this number right here. So this is my number without sales tax. And I'm just going to click on the bottom right hand corner of the cell right here where I get this thin cross and just drag my formula down to the rest of these cells. So that is one way to calculate your sales before tax, given your sales with tax. But we go into some more options on how to do this out on our blog, and I'm going to include a link to that blog entry in the description below on YouTube if you would like to go there and learn more. If you have questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.